Where can a feller have the time of his life this summer? Years ago, campers came to Phantom Lake by interurban trains, bicycles, horses, and today campers continue to pour into Phantom Lake each season by chartered bus, by airplane, or by mom or dad's special chauffeuring. No matter the kind of transportation, they all come for the same reason today as they did 50 years ago. The reason is for fun. Before you know it, you are on your own, ready to explore all the crooks and crannies of camp. And the first place to head for is the sandy beach of crystal clear Phantom Lake. Oh boy, I get to go swimming right away. That's right, pal. Everyone is given a beginning swim period or a test to find out what part of the swimming area he can swim in and be assigned a buddy number. Safety. Your safety first is our motto. And while you are swimming, understanding staff are eager to teach and help you learn. The old timers know the ropes, and they quickly help the new guys learn all about it. Flipping the canoe is almost that easy, but it's just a wee bit heavier. Okay, so you were a minnow to start with. Every day, swim lessons will soon make you a fish. Flying fish, or maybe a shark. Expert swimming instruction prepares you for personalized lessons in the rowboats. Top flight college students and athletes are well qualified to teach you the rules of the fleet, parts of a rowboat, and how to make it turn the right direction. Who knows? After much patience and hard work, you may even be able to row in a straight line. For the better swimmers, there is the thrill and excitement of the sleek silver and white canoes. The fleet of 18 canoes are ready to challenge your balance and strength. You learn all the strokes and what to do when the critter goes bottoms up. The older and more experienced swimmers spend many long hours learning about sailboats. There are knots to learn and how to rig for an exciting run. Lessons on land must be learned first, and boy, that sure is tough. But soon those lessons pay off as you skipper a sailing dinghy on Phantom's blue waters. What do you mean, I can't hit the broadside of a barn? Listen, bud, I'm in the cleanup slot on the Wise Owls Little League team. I'm terrific on grounders, but when it comes to fly balls, I need a bushel basket. Anyway, with my slugging, we'll win the camp championship. Win, lose, or draw in the old ball game, it is time for everyone to go for a general swim. No lessons now, just splish, splash, and diving till the ears pop. Now I know why I had that swim test the first day and why my counselor made me learn my buddy number. What was it now? Buddy call, buddy call. Now where is he? He was here just a minute ago. Oh, there he is, under the water, hunting for his stubbed toe. Everyone finds his partner, the fellow he checked in to go swimming with. Okay, so it does take some time. But remember, time lost is always better than looking for a missing camper. Safe swimming practices are always followed. Competent lifeguards are stationed at close intervals to supervise all swimming, to see that you enjoy yourself surely and safely. Remember, no running on the pier and one on the diving board at a time, just like in your own Y pool back home. Over so soon, and time to check out of the swimming area until another day. Those lucky counselors, now that they chased us out, they can horse around and take a soap dip. They need a few minutes to get a dip, and by the time they get to the shower, we've used all the hot water. Besides the regular activities at Phantom, there are some special events like Turtle Downs, the Crier, and probably the best one of all is the Big Chuck Wagon Meal. Big pans of baked beans, hot dogs or barbecue, potato chips, bug juice, and cake, all ready for the mammoth appetites of eager campers. After a busy day and a Big Chuck Wagon feed, it's time for a rowboat trip into the swamp to hunt turtles for turtle downs or frogs for the frog jumping contest. Or maybe it is the time to get together with your pal for a relaxing sail in the evening as the sun begins to draw the curtain on another day. With the boat securely tied up, it's off to Alford Lodge for Camper Talent Night under the supervision of the old stage master, Big Bear Berenger. There are tales of Wyatt Earp, stories, weightlifting, musical numbers. Everyone is an actor. Who knows? You too may be another Fred McMurray. With the bugle sounding reveille, you bounce outside to be greeted by the sun shining over Alford Lodge. And after the necessary trip to the greenhouse, everyone starts the day with flag raising and the Pledge of Allegiance. While the staff meets on the porch to plan or get a rest, all is made spick and span. Each day there is a password on the flagstones and tent devotions at night, but Sunday is a special day. After Mrs. T's famous sweet rolls for breakfast, we head for chapel in the pines where we sit on the pine needles and worship together. It is a bit strange to be in church outside. No walls, just pine trees, and our voices blend in with the outdoor sounds. As we sit in the chapel in the pines close together, we realize that we are all God's handiwork. We have been invaded. Nope, it's just visitor's day, and time for Mom and Dad to check up on me with the counselor. We've got to get a picture or two to prove to Gramps and Grandpa that I was at camp. Visitor's Day is a real great day at camp. People are everywhere, but mostly at the waterfront watching the big water show. Mom, Dad, sisters, brothers, and cousins are all here. Gosh, even the pets. This is my chance to show the folks how much I have learned in swimming. Our tent has fellows in the two-man swims, pajama races, watermelon push, and ping pong ball push. Anyway, everyone in our tent has a chance to get in on the act. You know, there can't be a swimming show without the diving clowns. Wow, shades of Granddad's day. He must have hit bottom and bounced back. It's soon time for the folks to leave, but I'm going to stay right here at camp and learn all those fancy dives. No water show can be complete without a boating show. Tying two canoes together seems like a hard way to get nowhere. And it is. Sorry, Dads, you can't get in on the act. Besides, it will only mean aches and blisters. It may be tough to get campers' hands under the water faucet, but there's no problem when it comes to getting them in the lake. Come on, fellas. You don't want to bail the lake into the canoe. Oh, well, what's the use? It's a big lake. Some wise guy swiped our oars, but we'll make it anyway. That is what is known as a slow boat to Phantom. What are those, barges? No, sir. Those are the war canoes, the safest craft on the lake and are terrific in races. The fishermen really need to look out and head for shore when they see a war canoe bearing down on them. The camp director seems happy about it all. Must be that there were few complaints today or he scared his secretary into action. The big three, literally and figuratively. Program Director Don Berenger, Girls Head Counselor Lynn Vandemore, and Camp Director Lee McIver compare notes in preparation for Girls Camp. For over 30 years, girls have been camping at Phantom during the month of August. What an enthusiastic bunch, enjoying all camp activities, including nature lore, and feeding the fish. Fishing. Like the boys, the girls know a good thing and receive sympathetic care at the health lodge. All money is put in the bank for safekeeping, and each day your counselor tells you how you are doing. The hot, sticky, muggy days at camp might be tough for the baseball game, but the craft shop is always cool. For those of you interested in leatherwork, carving, metal, lacing, and the craft shop offers items at all prices. They even have wood burning, sometimes better known as finger burning, by accident, of course. A cool drink from the Phantom Well refreshes you for more fun. Every camper wants to cook over the hot coals, sit around that same small fire, popping popcorn, roasting marshmallows, and telling tall tales, and to sleep on the ground in a cozy tent. The Gypsy Village, located away from camp, offers those thrills and excitement. Will you get to wear Robin Hood's hat today for the highest score on the archery range? Who knows until you try? It takes concentration, strength, and a steady hand to zero in on a bullseye. Well, maybe no bullseye, but I'm getting pretty close, and I can practice every day. America is a land of sportsmen and hunters, and who doesn't dream of being a big game hunter someday? With millions of families owning and using guns, it is important to properly learn how to handle a rifle. The 22 rifle range is always busy under the eagle eye of a skilled leader. With a counselor from faraway India, it is fun to learn respect for guns as you try to become the top marksman in camp. Hey, look, I've hit a bullseye. How did you make out? Gosh, I'm going to get my marksmanship award. The combination game of soccer and baseball called kickball is great sport and is a good inter-tent challenge event. Everyone has a favorite program, but there is one program at camp that no one misses. You guessed it, chow time. With all the activity at camp, a feller needs 3 square meals a day. When the chow bell rings, everyone gets back to his tent and all together head over the hill to the dining hall on the lake. Before each meal, time is taken while grace is sung, and a camper gives a spoken word of thanks to God for all the wonderful food. For such delicious meals as Swiss steak, roast beef, chicken, ham, spaghetti and meatballs, hamburgers, hot dogs, and all the fresh milk you want. The evening rides are quite an event at Phantom. The 6 riders and the riding master head out of camp into the west for Brady Brady Land in search of the Brady Brady Indians. As they wind through the heavily wooded trails, maybe they will meet Cochise or a friendly settler to show them the way to the heavily laden wild blackberry bushes. As each day of camp goes by and campers make new friends, they meet together in the early evening to talk over the day's activities, to share their conquests, their disappointments, and their secrets with each other. They meet together to hatch up new tricks, to play on their counselor and their campmates, and to make plans for tomorrow's early morning fishing jaunt, or a tennis match, or maybe a nature hike. A million ideas and dreams are theirs, and taking time to just lean against a tree in the setting sun, just sort of unlaxing, is part of a camp day. And as campers make new plans for tomorrow, the riders return out of the twilight, slowly heading back to the stables, and with great stories to tell. It's fun to sit on the Indian Village rail fence watching the camp day end. But fellers, you can't sit on that rail fence forever swapping stories. It is time to get ready to take your daily shower. Remember, Mom and Pop bought that toothpaste to be used.